Well, we were just saying to Debbie Gibson here that, I mean, you know, you must be sick of the 50s, because that's obviously where Greece is set, but you can't, you're saying you got enough of it.
No, I love it. Yeah. I love it. I've always loved it. Which is why when I found out I had gotten the role, I was so excited. I thought, yes, I get to live it every night, you know. I mean, a few of the songs that play in between you get kind of, you know, sick of, but...
Yeah, but the actual, the ambience, the 50s feel.
The whole stuff, yeah, I mean, the idea that girls are very girly and guys are, you know, tough and short hair, and I like that. Right. I like that, yeah.
You actually was just saying the other day, that because it was all over the newspapers, that the Duchess of York brought her two little girls, because was it Eugenie's third birthday treat?
Fourth birthday. Yes.
And they sat in a box with their fingers over their ears.
Yes, they were sitting in, like, the producer's box, which is right in front of the speakers, and it was blaring out at them, and there they were, four and I don't know how old.
Well, about a year or two.
I
mean, they're both
something.
Very young. They must have, you know... There were so many kids. There was so. I didn't know you could fit that many people in the box. Actually, it was fun that we went back and had some birthday cake and gingerbread cookies and things.
Were they good?
Oh yeah, they were funny. I was teaching them the little jive that they do in the hop scene, and they were dancing and throwing each other under each other's legs and twirling. And
oh great!
They were really cute.
I think we've got a little clip actually. Should we have a look?
Yeah,
Greece.
You better shape up.
It's interesting, in this country, when you got the part, all the headlines said, you know, American pop star Debbie Gibson gets part. But actually, sure, you're a pop star, but you've not been away from the stage for more than 6 months in your life, have you?
No.
You're far more stage-oriented.
Yes, I started in theatre when I was 5 years old. And so it was the same thing because I did Les Mis on Broadway, and when I went into that, it was kind of like, oh, another pop singer, I think she's a musical theatre actress person. And I was saying, no, you don't understand, I've spent my whole life doing this, you know.
So how come you're so well-adjusted? I mean, we hear so much about child stars who've really, actually, by the time they're your age, that they're in the throes of anorexia or drugs or terribly emotional problems.
It's funny, it's like, put it this way, okay, last night I got in at about, you know, 11 after the show or whatever, and I'm thinking, I have to go to sleep. And this is how pop people and theater people get hooked on drugs, because you go, I have to go to sleep. You know, so here I am taking my, like, valerian root quiet night herbal tablets or something. And my mother's on the other end going, don't take too much stuff, you know, don't take too much. And it's like a joke, but, I mean, I don't even like to take aspirin. I mean, that's how far away from it I am.
Yeah. But I think is it this very close relationship with your parents that you were talking about earlier?
I think so, yeah. Yeah, I've got a family that will not let me get out of line, or they'll just give me a smack me upside the head, you know.
Whereabouts are you from in the States?
New York.
New York, yeah.
Long Island, darling. Yes. I don't talk like that anymore.
How often do you phone them, then? How often do you talk while you're about?
I speak to my mother every day. I speak to my dad about once a week. I speak to my sisters on a regular basis. Yeah,
that's close.
And she's, as we were saying earlier when we had our little chat about sex education, which is the subject of the phone-in today, you were saying that your parents told you everything frankly and freely, but actually taught you how to value yourself.
Yes, yes. And that's always been their view on everything. I mean, anything that I've ever done in my life, it's been my choice, and I've always just had background information which enabled me to make my own choices, whether it be kind of, you know, what profession I wanted to be in, whether it was relating to drugs, sex, whatever. I always had enough information to make my own choices. And it's amazing what happens when you allow kids to make their own choices. Quite often they make the right ones. But if you're sitting there going, no, it's bad, it's taboo, they're going to want to try it.
What about this stalker that we read about, this guy who was following you around? Is that puffed up, or is it
that
was true?
That was majorly puffed up. I mean, it's true, but, you know, it's like, I think every performer has somebody that's after them or obsessed with them or whatever, and especially being young and female, it goes with the territory. But I don't allow that to kind of like, I'm not a recluse or anything, but you know, I do take the proper security measures when I need to, you know, and that's basically it, you know. But it's not like they made it sound like she never leaves the house and she's terrified of it. I'm not afraid. I believe, you know, I'm a believer in when your number's up, basically. So
fatalistic.
Whatever.
Well, look, Greece finishes soon, doesn't it?
Well, I finish in it. It continues. Right. Yeah, I mean, I'm finishing in 2.5 weeks.
Right.
Sonia, who actually is from this neck of the woods, she's coming in.
Oh, she's
lovely,
Sonia.
Met her yet, though.
She's very sweet. She's a really sweet girl. And what are you doing?
I'm going home to record a new album.
Mm-hmm. Right. So it's back to the pop.
Yeah.
Back to
the writing and the.
Well, what are you doing for us at the end of the show?
Hopelessly devoted and probably a hopeless rendition of it because I've been up since 5 this morning.
And you've had a very bumpy plane ride in the little this morning plane. Yes.
Not so good idea.
Twin propellers and not much fun.
I bet it'll be great. We look forward to hearing it. Thanks very much indeed, Debbie.
Okay.
Thanks.